Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss solved problems of the chapter matrices from Mathematics 1A, Telugu Academy. If you didn't watch the previous videos, the link is in the description, have a look at. So first solved problem they gave is, they gave one matrix A, 1, 2, 3, minus 5. And they're asking to find the adjoint as well as inverse of this matrix. Okay, first to find out the adjoint, we need to find out the cofactors. So first row, first element, if we take minus 1 power first row, first element. This minus 1 is common for all the numbers, whatever we are going to find now. Power, which element we are taking? We are selecting first row, first column. So that's why first row plus first column. Now, remove that complete first row as well as first column. Then what element we remained with? It is minus 5. So write that minus 5 here. This calculation I will do later. First, let me finish this completely. Next, again, minus 1 power first row, second column element. Now I am checking. So, first row, second column element. If we remove that one, we remains with the number 3. Next, the same way, minus 1 whole power second row, first column. The same way, minus 1 whole power second row, second column. Okay, let us check what numbers we remain with. First, second row, first column. This is second row, this is first column. So, remainder number is 2. Next, we want second row, second column. Second row, second column. So, remains with 1. Okay, let us do this calculation now. Minus 1 whole power 1 plus 1 is 2 into minus 5, which is nothing but minus 1 whole square plus 1, 1 into minus 5, it is minus 5. Minus 1 whole power 1 plus 2, minus 1 whole power 3 into 3. Minus 1 whole power 3, minus 1 into 3. Minus 1 into 3, it's nothing but minus 3. Next, minus 1 whole power 3 into 2, which is equals to minus 1 into 2. Next comes minus 1 whole power 2 plus 2, 4 into 1, which is equals to minus 1 whole power 4 is 1, 1 into 1, it's nothing but 1 again. So now, by using these elements, whatever we got just now, let us write a matrix in the same order again. This is first row, first column, this is first row, second column, second row, first column, second row, second column. So minus 5, minus 3. Minus 5, minus 3, minus 2, 1, minus 2, 1. This is a matrix which formed by cofactors of elements. Okay, now, for this matrix which we got by writing all the cofactors of the elements, if we just transpose that matrix, we will get adjoint. So, transposing is nothing but writing the row as column and a column as a row. So minus 5 minus 2, this is the first column, right? Let us write the same elements as the row. So minus 5 minus 2, this is the second column, let us write it as second row, minus 3 plus 1. So this is the transpose of the cofactors matrix. So this is nothing but adjoint of a matrix. Okay, in the question he asks us to find out the adjoint. Okay, we did the adjoint. Now, we need to find the inverse also. So, A inverse is nothing but 1 by determinant into adjoint of a matrix. So, first let us find out the determinant. 1 by determinant is nothing but AD minus BC. So, let us check what it is that. This is AD minus BC. 1 into minus 5, minus 5. 3 into 2, 6. Minus 5, minus 6. Determinant is 1 by minus 5, minus 6 into adjoint. Just now we got that is minus 5, minus 2, minus 3, 1. Let us simplify this. 1 by minus 5, minus 6, minus 11 times minus 5 minus 2 minus 3 1. Okay, let us multiply this with each and every element which is inside. Minus 5 by minus 11, it will become 5 by 11. Minus 2 by minus 11, 2 by 11. Minus 3 by minus 11, 3 by 11. 1 by minus 11, minus 1 by 11. This is nothing but inverse of the given matrix A. Okay, let us check the second solved problem now. In this, they give matrix A as 1, 3, 3, 1, 4, 3, 1, 3, 4. And in this also, he is asking us to find the adjoint of the matrix as well as inverse of the matrix. So, whether it may be 2 by 2 matrix or 3 by 3 matrix, the process is same. Let us check it out now. Okay, first as usual, minus 1 power, first row, first column. I'll write all at a time. Minus 1 power, first row, second column. Minus 1 power, first row, third column. After finishing this, I'll move to later. Okay, now, first I'm going with the first row, first column. First row, first column. If I remove this, remaining I got one 2 by 2 matrix. This is 2 by 2 matrix, right? So, for that 2 by 2 matrix, I will find out the determinant. And that determinant, I will write it here. So, what I will get here, determinant? 4 4s are 16 minus 3 3s are 9. Okay, this is what we got. This calculation I will do later. First, let me finish the process. Okay, next comes. First row, second column. First row, second column. Then we got 1, 3, 1, 4 as a 2 by 2 matrix. So, 1, 4 is a 4 minus 1, 3 is a 3. Next, first row, third column. This is first row, this is third column. So, we remains with 1, 3 is a 3 minus 1, 4 is a 4. So, we get it as 3 minus 4. Okay, now let us simplify this. Minus 1 whole power 1 plus 1 is nothing but 2 into 16 minus 9, 7. Minus 1 whole square is plus 1 into 7, 7. Minus 1 whole power 1 plus 2 is 3 times 4 minus 3, 1. Minus 1 whole power 3 is minus 1 into 1, minus 1. Next comes minus 1 whole power 1 plus 3, 4 into 3 minus 4, minus 1. Minus 1 whole power 4 is plus 1 into minus 1, it is minus 1. Okay, first row completed. Now let us move to the second row then. First I will write these all here. Minus 1 whole power second row first column. Minus 1 whole power second row second column. Minus 1 whole power second row third column. Okay, let us simplify this. First, second row first column. This is second row and this is first column. Now if we remove this here, 3, 3, 3, 4. So these 4 together will become a 2 by 2 matrix. So let us find out the determinant. 3, 4 is a 12 minus 3, 3 is a 9. 12 minus 9. 12 minus 9. Next, second row, second column. This is second row and this is second column. So, if you find out the determinant, 1 4 is a 4 minus 1 3 is a 3. 4 minus 3. Next, second row, third column. This is already second row, now third column. So, we remains with 1 3 is a 3 minus 1 3 is a 3. So, 3 minus 3. 3 minus 3. Let us simplify this further. Minus 1 whole power 2 plus 1 3 into 12 minus 9 3. Minus 1 whole power 3 is minus 1. So minus 1 into 3, it's minus 3. Next, minus 1 whole power 2 plus 4 is 4. 4 minus 3 is 1. Minus 1 whole power 4 is 1. 1 into 1, 1. Minus 1 whole power 2 plus 3 is 5. 5 into 0. Anything into 0 is 0 only always. Okay, second row also completed. Now let us move to the third row. First I will write this all. Then after we will move there. Minus 1 whole power, third row first column. Minus 1 whole power, third row second column. Minus 1 whole power, third row third column. Okay, let us write. First, I'm going with third row first column. This is third row and this is first column. So, we remain with 3 3s are 9 minus 4 3s are 12. 9 minus 12. 9 minus 12. Next, third row, second column. This is third row and this is second column. 1, 3 is a 3 minus 1, 3 is a 3. 3 minus 3. 3 minus 3. Next, third row, third column. Third row, third column. 1, 4 is a 4 minus 1, 3 is a 3. 4 minus 3. 4 minus 3. Okay, let us simplify this. Minus 1 whole power 3 plus 1, 4 into 9 minus 12 minus 3. Minus 1 whole power 4 plus 1 into minus 3 minus 3. Next, minus 1 whole power 3 plus 2, 5 into 3 minus 3, 0, 0 into anything, 0. Next, minus 1 whole power 3 plus 3, 6 into 4 minus 3, 1. Minus 1 whole power 6 plus 1, 1 into 1, 1. Okay, now we got all the cofactors of each and every element. Now by using all these cofactors in the same order, let us create the cofactor matrix. So first row, 7 minus 1 minus 1. 7 minus 1 minus 1. Next, second row, minus 3, 1, 0. Minus 3, 1, 0. And third row, minus 3, 0, 1. Minus 3, 0, 1. Okay, this is the matrix which we got through cofactors. Now, we want adjoint. So, simply transpose this cofactors matrix. So, this is total first column. Let us write this as a first row. 7, minus 3, minus 3. This is second column, write it as second row, minus 1, 1, 0. Third column, write it as third row, minus 1, 0, 1. So, this newly formed matrix will become adjoint matrix. Okay, now we need to find out the inverse for this. So, matrix inverse is nothing but 1 by determinant into adjoint matrix. Okay, 1 by, to find out the determinant, I'll write the matrix again here. What is the matrix they give? 1, 3, 3, 1, 4, 3. 1, 3, 3, 1, 4, 3, 1, 3, 4. Okay, this is the matrix they give. Let me confirm once again. Okay, 1, 3, 3, 1, 4, 3, 1, 3, 4. Okay, done. Now, for this 3 by 3 matrix, we need to find out the determinant. Okay, let us do that. Here plus, here minus, here plus. So 1 into 4, 4 is a 16 minus 3, 3 is a 9. Next to minus 3 into 1, 4 is a 4 minus 1, 3 is a 3. 4 minus 3. Next to plus 3 into this third row, third column. 1, 4 is a 4, sorry, 1, 3 is a 3 minus 1, 4 is a 4. 1, 3 is a 3 minus 1, 4 is a 4. So now what we will get? 1 into 16 minus 9, 7 minus 3 into 4 minus 3, 1 plus 3 into 3 minus 4, minus 1, 7 minus 3 into 1, minus 3 plus 3 into minus 1, minus 3. So 7 minus 6, that is nothing but 1. So determinant we got as 1. Here I am writing 1 by determinant is 1. Into adjoint matrix, 7 minus 3 minus 3. Next, minus 1 plus 1, 0. Minus 1, 0, 1. Okay, now here 1 by 1 is nothing but 1 only. So 1, if you multiply with any number also, we will get the same number only. So the adjoint matrix itself is the inverse in this case. So 7 minus 3 minus 3 minus 1, 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 1. This is the inverse of the given matrix A. Okay, let us check the third solved problem. They gave a matrix A that is 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2. And is asking to show that it is non-singular matrix as well as to find the inverse matrix. So what is the non-singular matrix means? First of all, non-singular matrix is nothing but if the determinant of a matrix is zero, it is called as singular. In case if the determinant of a matrix is not equals to zero, then it is non-singular. So let us first find the determinant of this matrix. So determinant of A equals to, this will become plus minus plus. So 1 into first row, first column, if we remove, 2 2s are 4 minus 1 3s are 3. Next, second element if we take, that is minus 2 into 3 2s are 6 minus 1 3s are 3. Then last first 1 into, if we remove this also, 3 1s are 3 minus 1 2s are 2. So 1 into 4 minus 3 1 minus 2 into 6 minus 3 3 plus 1 into 3 minus 2 1. So we will get it as 1 1s are 1 minus 2 3s are 6 plus 1, which is equals to 1 plus 1 2 2 minus 6, that is minus 4. We can say clearly minus 4 is not equals to 0, then this is non-singular. If it is 0, we will call it as singular. Okay, now we need to find out the A mat inverse. So for that, first of all, we want cofactors of all the elements. Let us find those cofactors first of all. Minus 1, first row, first element, sorry, first column, first row, second column, first row, third column. Okay, after finishing the first row, I'll move to the second row. So for my easy calculation, I am drawing the matrix here only again. 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2. Okay, now I am going with the first row, first column. So this is first column, first row. I am removing it. So remaining will be 2, 2 is a 4, minus 1, 3 is a 3. 4 minus 3. Next comes with the first row, second column. That is first row, this is second column. 3, 2 is a 6, minus 1, 3 is a 3. Next, first row, third column. That is 3 1s are 3 minus 1 2s are 2. Okay, the see. First, let me complete five this one. Then after, I'll move to the second row, which is equals to minus 1 power 1 plus 1 2 into 4 minus 3 1. Minus 1 power 2 is 1. 1 into 1, 1. Which is equals to minus 1 whole power 1 plus 2 is 3 into 6 minus 3, 3. Minus 1 power 3 is minus 1, minus 1 into 3, it is minus 3. Next, minus 1 power 1 plus 3 is 4 into 3 minus 2, 1. So our answer will be 1 again. Now let's move to the second row. That can be written as minus 1 power second row first column, minus 1 power second row second column, minus 1 power second row third column. So for this also, again for easy calculation, I am writing the matrix here only. Our matrix is 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2. First, second row, first column. This is second row, first column. Then we remains with 4, 2 2s are 4, minus 1 1s are 1, 4 minus 1. Next, second row, second column, 1 2s are 2, minus 1 1s are 1, 2 minus 1. Then comes second row, third column. This is the third column. 1 1s are 1, minus 1 2s are 2, 1 minus 2. Okay, I'll rub this and I'll simplify this. Then after, I'll move to the third row. Minus 1 whole power 2 plus 1 is 3 into 4 minus 1 is 3. So minus 1 power 3 is minus 1, minus 1 into 3, minus 3. Minus 1 whole power 2 plus 2 is 4, 2 minus 1 is 1. Minus 1 whole power 4 is plus 1, 1 into 1, 1. Next comes minus 1 power 2 plus 3, 5 into 1 minus 2, minus 1. Minus 1 power 5 is minus 1, minus 1 into minus 1, plus 1. Second row also completed. Now let's move to the third row. Minus 1 power third row first column, minus 1 power third row second column, minus 1 power third row third column. Okay, for that again I am drawing the matrix. Our matrix is given as 1 2 1 3 2 3 1 1 2. Okay, first we want third row first column. So third row first column, if we remove, 2 3s are 6 minus 2. In the same way, third row second column, then we remains with, I'll do it again, 1 3s are 3 minus 1 3s are 3. So 3 minus 3. Next third row, third column. 1, 2 is 2 minus 3, 2 is 6. Okay, let us check it out now. Minus 1 whole power 3 plus 1 is 4 into 6 minus 2 is 4. So minus 1 whole power 4 is plus 1. 1 into 4, 4 only again. Next comes minus 1 power 3 plus 2 is 5. 5 into 3 minus 3 is 0. Minus 1, 0 into anything is 0. Next, minus 1 whole power 3 plus 3 is 6 into 2 minus 6 minus 4. Minus 1 power 6 is plus 1. Plus 1 into minus 4 minus 4. So we got all the 3 rows elements. Then let us write the cofactors matrix. So first row comes as 1 minus 3 1. 1 minus 3 1. And second row will be minus 3 1 1. Minus 3 1 1. Then third row will be 4 0 minus 4. 4 0 minus 4. Next, let us write the adjoint matrix. Just transpose this. This is first column. Write it as first row. 1 minus 3 4. This is second column. Write it as second row. Minus 3 1 0. This is third column. Write it as third row. 1 1 minus 4. So this is the adjoint matrix. Okay, next what is asking them to find the inverse matrix. So A inverse is nothing but 1 by determinant into adjoint. So first only we did the determinant. How much determinant we got? Yes, this one. That is minus 4. So let us substitute that minus 4 there. So we will get equals to 1 by minus 4 into adjoint. Adjoint is how much? 1 minus 3 4. 1 minus 3 4 minus 3 1 0 1 1 minus 4. Okay, now if we simplify this, minus 1 by 4 3 by 4 minus 1 3 by 4 minus 1 by 4 0 again minus 1 by 4 minus 1 by 4 minus 4 by minus 4 is nothing but 1. Okay, this is the required inverse matrix of the matrix A. Till now, if you didn't subscribe to my channel, subscribe for more videos. Thank you.